I'm live. Here we go. Happy Mother's Day. You know how I wake up on my Sundays. I woke up this morning with my mind. Sing it where you are. Stay. Talking, yeah, walking and talking with my mind singing. Stay on spirit. On spirit. Walking and talking with my mind. Stay on spirit. Walking and talking with my mind. Stay on spirit. Hallelujah.
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 Mind, sing along with me. Stay on spirit. Singing my song with my mind. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Stay on spirit. Singing my song with my mind. Stay on spirit. Hallelujah.
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 Come on, sing with me. Well, I woke up this morning, yeah. Woke up this morning. Along with me. I hear you singing, Maria. Woke up this morning with my mind. Hey, Barb and Christine. Hey. Good morning, Mel and Joe. Woke up this morning with my mind. Hello, Pam. Hey. Started our beautiful Mother's Day celebration. We had three amazing men cook us breakfast this morning. Something about this isolation in a pod is working for me. I am blessed. I am blessed. Every day of my life, I am blessed, 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 blessed. When I wake up in the morning or lay my head to rest, I am blessed. You are.
You are blessed.
Oh, you are blessed.
You are blessed.
Yeah, you are blessed. Every day of your life, you are blessed, 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 blessed. When you wake up in the morning or lay your head to rest, you are blessed. You are blessed. We are. Sing it out.
We are blessed.
Oh, we are blessed.
We are blessed.
Blessed, 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 blessed. When we wake up in the morning and lay our head to rest, we are blessed. We are blessed. Here's Laura's solo. Laura, this is you. We are blessed. That's right. We are blessed. I hear ya. Every day of our lives, we are blessed, 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 blessed. When we wake up in the morning or lay our head to rest, we are blessed. Keep it there. We are blessed. One more time. We are blessed. We are blessed. Nice singing, everybody. Give yourself some love. Dr. Deborah Gordon.
Woo-hoo. Good morning, everybody. What a delight to see you out there in virtual land. I was thinking about it. I've been saying welcome, Facebook land, but now we're actually translating these to be posted on YouTube afterwards. And so it really occurred to me that, you know, you can watch it now, hello. You can watch it later, hello. I just want to be inclusive and make sure that everybody is duly welcome for sure. And how beautiful it is, really, that the technology in our world lets us to participate right here and now or later in the day, kind of whatever works for us. So it's a good and beautiful thing. And so today is Mother's Day, and so happy Mother's Day to all of you. And we're blessed to have somebody from our six-person pod this morning who is typically behind the camera who's going to be front and center today. So great fun to have Amanda Pope. And, oh, I'm out of breath, all that singing and jumping around. It's fun, yes, and all that, the bacon and eggs and the blueberry pancakes that we were so blessed to have. So happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. And I am very aware that this is the day that we acknowledge mothers and show our gratitude. I also know that maybe not everybody out there had the very best experience of mother. And in some way, shape, or form, though, we have all been blessed by some form of mothering. So there's lots of men and women out there who are single parents carrying out both mothering and fathering. There are a lot of same-sex parents, grandparents raising grandchildren, foster parents, et cetera, et cetera. And for sure, the faces and the roles of families in our society today are changing. And what might have been the norm in the past, nowadays there's a lot of diversity in what families are and what that role of mother is. But what I want is for everybody to feel valued, seen, and needed, and to appreciate that there is a wide continuum of that thing called mothering. And so for every person out there who nurtures in any way, shape, or form, I just want to say thank you for doing that. So to move us into our service today, I'm going to share a writing. It's a little bit lengthy, but I think it is so beautiful and couldn't be more perfect for today. And it's a writing from the Prime Minister of New Zealand. Her name is Jacinda Ardern. And she part of this was originally in Maori, but I'm going to translate them for all of us. And this is actually an ode, a tribute to Mother Earth. So if you're comfortable, you can close your eyes just to hear these words more deeply in your hearts. Rest now, Mother Earth. Breathe easy and settle. Right here where you are. We'll not move upon you for a while. We'll stop. We'll cease. We'll slow down and stay home. Draw each other close and be kind. Kinder than we've ever been. I wish I could say we were doing it for you as much as ourselves, but oh well, whatever, we're doing it anyway. It's right, it's time. Time to return, time to remember, time to listen and forgive. Time to withhold judgment, time to cry, time to think. Remove our shoes, press hands to soil, lift grains between fingers. Gentle palms, time to plant, time to wait, time to notice to whom we belong. For now it's just you and the wind and the forests and the oceans and the sky full of rain. It's finally raining. Tears from the eyes of our Sky Father drip down on you. Embrace it. This sacrifice of solitude we have carved out for you. A small offering. People always said it wasn't possible to ground flights and stay home and stop our habits of consumption. But it was. It always was. We were just afraid of how much it was going to hurt. And it is hurting. And it will hurt and continue to hurt. But not as much as you have been hurt. So be still now. Wrap your heels around our absence. Loosen the concrete belt cinched tight at your waist. Rest, breathe, recover, heal, and we will do the same. Oh, our beautiful Mother Earth, resting and healing. So, just a little bit of FYI for what's going on. A reminder about our midweek faith lift being hosted by our compassionate care team each and every Wednesday, a place to connect, a place to really have the opportunity to be together in safety and in love. That's Wednesdays from 7 to 8. The Zoom link is in our newsletter. Make sure you are signed up for that. You can sign up on our website. Also, our children's program, The Vibe, which stands for Vibrant Individuals Being Educated, is continuing to offer our children's program on Zoom. So anyone with children anywhere is invited to be a part of that, but you do need to get a special private meeting number and password. And probably the best way to do that is you can email me personally, and I'll be happy to send that on to you. My email is revgroward@shaw.ca, and maybe Derek will put that in there. Also, I want to give my personal shout out of gratitude and thank you for those of you who are continuing your financial support through this odd time. You are keeping us functioning, and we are so, so, so grateful. Especially, I want to give a shout out of thanksgiving to our conscious givers who are out there, who are part of our strong foundation of financial support. And please know how grateful I am, and please know how we couldn't do it without you, and of course without all of you. So thank you for that. Really, that's one way that we know that this has meaning and value is by that support. And so I think that's it for now. And so what I am pretty knowing is that we have a song now to move us into one of my personal favorite spiritual practices, and that is our time of silence. Really that time to be still and to be in that space of gratitude and thanksgiving today. So peace and blessings. Barbara.
Thank you, Dr. Deborah. This is a song that was my mom's favorite song, and I would hear her singing it. And so I'm going to dedicate it to all those mamas out there.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a soul like me. But now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to feel, and grace that bright shining as the sun. We've no less days, oh, to sing, sing, sing God's praise, yes, than when we first begun. Sing from where you are. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a soul like me. I once was lost, oh, but now I'm found, was blind, but now I
thank you. Thank you. I can hear you singing all the way from here. We're going to go into that sacred space. And I know that we are honoring Mother Earth here today, as Dr. Deborah said, and all of the mothers. So as you go into your quiet, reflective moment, just embrace that goddess within you.
In this very room, there's quite enough love for all the world. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for all the world. And there's quite enough peace and quite enough power to walk through our every fear. For spirit, one spirit is in this very would stand with me where you are. We are one. We are one. I am you. You are me. We are one. And in this unity, we do live in harmony, and peace has come as we are one. And peace has come as we are one. In this place of unity, of harmony, of oneness, I recognize that we are all part of that one glorious, magnificent energy source supply of love everywhere. I speak my word for the Center for Spiritual Living. I speak my word for beautiful Amanda Pope as she comes to shine her light and share her message of love and motherhood. I speak my word for each and every mother that is out there, every aunt, every sister that has gone before us and that are standing with us now and are yet to come. I know that spirit is the driving force that moves us forward to that powerful source and supply that this beautiful Mother Earth is giving to each of us, through us, as us, for us. I know this is a day of celebration. I know it is one where the telephone lines are the busiest ever recorded in the entire world. So we are picking up and answering the call of love. We are answering the call of unity, of harmony, of oneness. I speak my word knowing that this is the truth, that love is spread everywhere across this entire globe. Mother Earth is nourished, and as she is nourished, so too are each of us. We accept the masculine and the feminine energy as that positive flare that is sparked everywhere. I am so profoundly grateful for this love that we share. I am so profoundly grateful for the opportunity to recognize this. I let this go back into the heart that beats us, each and every one of us. And together we say and solidify it by saying, and so it is. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my joy and honor to welcome to our stage, to our special platform, the one and only Amanda Pope.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us on this Mother's Day. It's been great to watch your comments. So I am usually behind the camera, and I am typing madly as you all join, and I'm saying good morning. And, you know, I was, out of all the volunteer jobs at the center, I've never been a greeter. So this last couple of months has been my foray into greeting, and I have loved it. We've talked about doing videos in different ways, but this Facebook Live has been so great because it feels like we're together. We're able to communicate back and forth. We're in community all together, and I love that. So for any of the technical difficulties we've had from it, I think it is so worth it in that we can talk to each other while the service is going on, and that's been such a gift for us, for sure. And we tend to, because we have nothing else to do right now, sit around after the service and we chat with each other. And often we're talking about, oh, did you see who was on? And did you see the comments? And so it's our way of really sort of celebrating this community and celebrating all of you, even though we can't be in the same room. So we so appreciate you being here. Yes, you can watch it after on YouTube, and the quality is actually even better there. But this is better because we get to be with each other in that same moment. So when Dr. Deb asked me to do a talk on Mother's Day, I thought, great, I'm a mom and I have a mom, so that would be easy. So I then started thinking about it and thinking, as Dr. Deb mentioned, about the complexity of motherhood and mothering. And then I just got a little bit nervous and I thought, oh boy, like all of a sudden, the happy Mother's Day with a big flower just did not encompass the complexity of mothering, motherhood. So I spent the week sort of really thinking about the people I know who are adoptive mothers, biological mothers who have put their children up for adoption. I have been thinking about step parents and just how mothering shows up for everybody, for me, for the people I love. And just knowing, I really truly want to honor the complexity of that relationship. Not just the Hallmark flowers and sunshine, happy Mother's Day, but the painful places and the joyous places, and that those sometimes happen in the same moment with the same person in the same family all at the same time. And so just so knowing that this is a day of honoring mothering. And, you know, if I just look at my own experience with mothering as a mother, as a stepmother, as having my own mother, my stepmother, my grandmothers, and I have an older sister who has definitely stepped in as a mothering figure in my life, and like we don't even have time to unpack all of that. So I just really want to honor each one of you and your experience with mothering, your experience right now as we are in these unusual times, and that you may not be able to see your mother today. You may have spent 24/7 with your kids for the last 2 months and may think that the best Mother's Day thing you could have would be to actually have some space today. All of that is part of this day, and I really, really, truly want to honor that. You know, life is messy, and so is motherhood and mothering, and I just truly want to honor all of that. And so I want to take us into that concept of mothering today, because I think it's different than motherhood, and mothering shows up in a lot of different ways. I looked in the dictionary for some definitions around mothering, motherhood, mother, and I came across this adjective on mothering that talks about the characteristic of being caring, protective, and kind. And I thought, oh, isn't that a great way to think of it? Just that mothering space. And we often think of it, you know, as unconditional love, just that container. And it made me think about when I gave birth to my son 22 years ago. He was born by a cesarean section, so I had to stay in hospital a couple of days afterwards. And I was sitting there in the hospital. It was a very challenging labor. Ended up with a cesarean section, and I'm in the hospital. I'm in the UK. He was born in England, halfway across the world from everybody I know, pretty much. And I think the enormity of that moment started to sink in that first night. I was in a hospital room. He was right beside me. There was a very young mother in a bed beside me and her baby, and the two of them cried all night. And it was a really, really challenging time for me. And I think the enormity of the responsibility that I had stepped into by giving birth to this beautiful baby started to sink in. And what this really looked like and meant for me in my life, for him in his life. And this powerful connection, a being grew inside of my body. And it really started to sort of sink in of like that I need to be in service. I am in service to this little baby. And you may be thinking, aren't those the things you're supposed to think about before you decide to have kids? But let's not judge. I was a different person back then and didn't think through all of my decisions. So anyway, that was the moment that I decided to have that real awakening into what it means to be a mother. And honestly, I descended into panic thinking, I am completely ill-prepared for this. I am self-absorbed. I was very young. How on earth could I do this? And so in that, I've been awake for several days. I've that trauma to my body, the emotional impact of having a baby. And this moment came to me and I thought, well, I'm overwhelmed and I'm panicking. So let's just think about this 1 year. From today for a year, I think about a one-year-old baby. Well, I mean, he doesn't really have to do anything by a year old. He doesn't need to be toilet trained. He doesn't even really need to be walking. He's not going to be talking or driving a car or anything. So really, for this year, I can just allow myself to simply love him and care for him. I don't need to do anything amazing. I don't need to expect anything from him, teach him anything. All I need to do is love him. And that, to this day, that was such a profound moment for me. And I wish I could tell you that every year after that, on his birthday, I made a commitment for that year and what's my vow, but to be honest, I think it went downhill from there. My best parenting moment may have been when he was less than 12 hours old. But that stuck with me. And it was just really, I defined mothering for myself. And the quote I chose for this week was from Eric Fromm. And it was, mother's love is peace. It need not be acquired. It need not be deserved. And if you think about that, that was what I was committing to. That was the moment that I had made that decision that all I needed was love, that he needed to do nothing to deserve or acquire my love. It was there, it was always present, and it was nothing beyond that that needed to be done. It was completely unconditional. And then I know a lot of parents out there are homeschooling right now, so I thought I would share a story about homeschooling my son. So we actually homeschooled for about 3 years, way before it was really cool or mandatory even. And, you know, the first year, there was a whole bunch of reasons why we ended up there. But anyway, the first year of homeschooling, I remember thinking, oh my God, I'm in charge of this child's education. I need to do everything right. So we followed the BC curriculum to the T. In that 1 year, we did 2 years of schooling. He did grade 2 and grade 3. And at the end of the year, I got him to do this, whatever the placement test, because apparently they have placement tests for kids who are in grade 3. And he did well. Like, that was the way I made it okay. I'm not completely destroying his life. I am actually educating him. But what I should tell you is he was not the most compliant and on board with this whole homeschooling thing. So it was not easy. I remember we had an actual teacher who was at Central School here in Kelowna, and I remember meeting with her, and I said, honestly, do we have to do spelling tests every week? Because they're going to kill me. They're just the level of screaming and crying and frustration, and that was just me. And she said, well, if you want him to learn how to spell, you need to do spelling tests. And I thought about it, and I thought, well, I know adults who can't spell. Okay, let's go back to not judging. These were desperate times. And I actually decided in that moment, I know you're judging me, to do away with spelling tests. The good news is I'd found a homeschool community, and I'd learned, and I'd read a lot. And what I realized is homeschooling is so much less about curriculum than it is about just living life in interesting ways. So the next 2 years, we just really let go of a lot of the real structure. I mean, structure is necessary in the school system because you're moving kids through in a way that supports this mass group of students going through. But when you're home and it's just mom and son, we just made life interesting. We read interesting books. We watched interesting movies. We went skiing, we went skating, we walked through the park and looked at different flowers, we grew a garden, we made bread, and we had crepes every Monday morning to celebrate that we weren't getting up and rushing out the door. We went to the Science Center all the time. Like, we just lived. And what's interesting to me is if I think back to that first day where I thought, all I need to do is love him and care for him, I realized that was true for homeschooling as well. We didn't need as much structure as I first thought we did. And again, I go back to how profound that was, that really all I needed to do was create a container of love and of peace, and he just thrived in it. And now, recognizing that we were not in a time of social distancing, and that, well, we were, because my son didn't want to hang out with other people, and so often we stayed at home, but we weren't in a time where we were all in social distancing, and things were a lot less uncertain then. But if you think about it now, families who are home, and even to expand out just into our community and thinking about where do we need to provide that loving, that mothering, that unconditional love? Where can we create a container of peace to hold people and support people while they're in this uncertain time? Because isn't that what mothers do? I mean, our kids, when they're little, they're scared, right? They have moments where they think there's a monster under their bed, where there's a spider, or maybe Barb still, there's a spider in their room, or anything like that. And things are uncertain and scary for them. And that's our job as in that mothering, is to just hold that space, knowing that it is all okay, that we can create that container of peace, that we can share that unconditional love. And I think that we see that. I see that on the news every night, where people are doing this for each other. Neighbors are doing this for other neighbors, where we're providing that mothering love and support in our community. It's a beautiful thing, knowing that it's happening in our healthcare system with those amazing frontline workers. So in your life, where can you think of the people that need that mothering? Or maybe it's you that needs the mothering. We all need that container of peace. We all need that unconditional love, absolutely. And so recognizing where it's necessary, when it's necessary. And that's what I want to do now, is sort of take that concept of mothering out onto the macro level. And so when I was in my moment of, oh my gosh, how am I going to do a talk on Mother's Day, I was on the internet and I was Googling things like mothering, mother, those kinds of things. And where I ended up was actually on watching the service of the Archbishop of Canterbury on Mothering Sunday. Oh. Pretty crazy, hey? So in England, Mother's Day is in March, and it's called Mothering Sunday often. They kind of go between the two because it's sort of a hybrid now with the North American. And anyway, so this is a total side note, though, I want to say, is that, so this is in March. It's just early days into the, you know, social distancing. So the Archbishop of Canterbury is doing his Mothering Sunday service in an empty cathedral with a small pod of people. And I was like, how wild is that? Like, we're pretty much doing the same thing here every Sunday morning as the Archbishop of Canterbury is. Although arguably a slightly nicer building than we do. But anyway, that was a side note. But he was talking about Mothering Sunday. And what's interesting is that Mothering Sunday actually dates back to the 16th century and has nothing to do with mothers. It was actually when British people would go to their mother church. And there was a fruitcake and whatever that... There was a whole ceremony about this, but it actually has a spiritual basis, not about mothers at all. And I thought, what an interesting parallel, because that's where I see this, is that mothering energy is very much the same as that spiritual energy that we all have access to. So I love how when I'm getting prepared for a talk, I can kind of just be led. So I've ended up in England with the Archbishop of Canterbury. Oh, it was so funny because he has his wife do the readings because they were social distancing, and so he had to keep it small. So it was really, I mean, it really made it pretty grassroots for them, even though it's such an epic place. So if we go back to that Eric Fromm quote, "Mother's love is peace. It need not be acquired, and it need not be deserved." And we get to that place of, if we take off the mother, that love is peace, that it need not be acquired, it need not be deserved. Well, and as we know, it is that power and that presence, that peace and love are those aspects of spirit, and they are within us at all times. And we have access to them, and we need not do anything to deserve them. They are always present. So I got to tell you that one of my favorite, well, actually, I think it is my favorite Ernest Holmes book, is called This Thing Called You. And I just love it. You know, it was written more than 20 years after the Science of Mind text, and I just find it, I find it personable, I find it easier to read, I find it clear. And I've been going through, in my time of spiritual practice, I've been going through the book just really slowly, and I just got stuck on one passage. And one of the things that Ernest Holmes does in this book is he writes to us, he writes these passages, and he's writing to us as though he is that word of spirit. So it's, and as he says, spirit is not personified. There is nothing out there. There's no person, anything out there, but it's personal to us, right? So this is, I think, just a beautiful way of experiencing that oneness and wholeness from that personal place. And so I've been stuck on this passage, and then wouldn't you know it, like just a day or two ago, Dr. Pat Campbell in Calgary posted it on Facebook, and I thought, there it is again. And I thought, well, it's just so relevant to the time we're in right now, and I think that capital M, mothering love. And so I'm going to, basically the passage is actually about that idea that we are free and we create our own experience, but there is that power for good that is impelling and compelling us forward. And so I'm just going to read you a little part of it. And this is what he says. "I have also placed within you a compass and a chart. There is a course you may pursue which leads to happiness, to wholeness, to peace of mind and joy. Someday you will follow this path because I have placed a spirit within you which is ever seeking to guide, ever standing aside, permitting you partially to obliterate that spark which is part of myself. Through all the rounds of experience, I am there." And this is the part I wanted to share. "Someday, when you sit down by the roadside, weary with struggle, you will listen deeply, and you will hear a voice saying, 'This is the path, follow it.' Even then, I shall wait, for you are you, and you cannot return to your mother's house other than as a complete and perfect individualization of myself. Always I shall be waiting. I shall not reproach you when you return. You will be welcome. The time of your return is in your own decision. It may be now or at any time in that vast forever which stretches before you. So over the last couple of months, when have you been weary with struggle? And it was such a great reminder of that still small voice within, that we are only one breath away from the peace that is residing within us. That in this moment, in this time that is unarguably very challenging in the world, where things, there's so much uncertainty around us, we have the ability to sit our weary selves down on the side of the road and take a breath. And that that presence of peace, that presence of love is right where we are. Is not saying, well, you made me wait, I'm going to make you wait. It is there. It is in that moment. It is in that breath. And that is that mothering, unconditional love in which we find peace, in which we find the power and the presence of the oneness of all life. And so I just want to encourage you this week to perhaps let go of expectations. If you're homeschooling yourself through this very rigid curriculum and expecting yourself to lose 20 pounds and save money and get a new job and write a book, that maybe all you need to do is sit down. That maybe the greatest gift you can give to yourself today is that mothering love. Maybe you see other people in your lives where they're maybe not at their best moment, and you can share that mothering love with them. Maybe you can just let that go of expectations for them and just share that peace, that power that is infinite, that is in us, that is always there. Thank you. Happy Mother's Day. Enjoy some mothering this week. Peace and blessings.
Thank you, Amanda. I remember early on in our relationship, I was at your place and Daniel was watching a show. I can't remember the name of it, but it was on PBS or the Knowledge Network or something. And it's how they make things and how they do things. And I love those sorts of shows, so I sat and watched it with him. And then when it was over, he said, okay, I can count my science for this week. And I went, wait, what? You get to watch TV and that counts for your class? But he's getting straight A's at University of British Columbia, so I guess you were doing something right. So I got to make this quick because I got to go and phone my mother. I just want to tell you how much, as Deb was saying earlier, how much we appreciate that you are still continuing to support us. And I know it's not easy. I know we're not together. We're not passing a basket because that's against the rules right now. But there are so many ways that you can support us, and we so much appreciate it. If you go on our website, you'll see that there's a donate button at the bottom. There's a myriad of ways that you can you can support us. You can mail us a check. You can e-transfer. You can go on to CAFT. We can set you up on that. If you have any questions at all, you can contact Dr. Deb or contact me, and we'll help you through it. So knowing that that is all said and done, I ask you to repeat this affirmation after me. I know that my giving blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, and all that I give and receive. Together we say, I do give eternal thanks for the abundance that is mine to share. You know what? I can hear you guys all saying that. I can hear it. Next week, we got a big treat. Dr. Ken is going to give us a talk. So I hope you join us again then. Thanks so much. Barb and Neal.
Thank you so much, Amanda. That was fantastic and so beautiful. You're so brilliant. I love it. And I know that you are going to embrace every moment that you have today to celebrate. And we are so grateful that you have joined us. Ooh, Neal put on the sunglasses. That's a sign something's going down. We're just going to say yes to more love, more joy, more connection. When love comes knocking at my door, I say yes, I say yes. When love comes dancing across my floor, I say yes, I say yes. When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes, just say yes, you gotta say yes. Hey, Alan, bless you too, Jan. And when freedom comes dancing on my floor,
I say yes, I say yes.
And when freedom comes dancing,
dancing across my floor.
I say yes.
Thanks, Sandy.
I say yes.
Oh, yeah. When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes, just say yes. You gotta say yes. Here comes the world. The world's a calling now. When the world comes knocking at my door, what you gonna say?
I say yes.
You say yes.
I say yes.
You say yes. And when the world comes dancing across my floor,
I say yes.
Oh, yeah,
say yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes, just say yes. You gotta say yes. Thanks for coming in, Kathy. Good to see ya. When love comes dancing across my floor,
I say yes.
I say yes.
I say yes.
Oh, thanks, Diana. I'm so happy to see everyone join us today. How blessed we are.
Yes,
yes, yes, yes,
yes,
yes. When we need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. I said yes, just say yes. You gotta say yes. We said yes to a beautiful breakfast. Thanks, guys. You're so good, treating us so well. Said yes. What are you gonna do with your yes today? Just say, well, you just said, come on and say yeah, yeah. Hey, Steffi, hey, Bren, we love you guys. See you next week. Peace and blessings, everyone.